channel Learning Made Simple and I am your physics lecturer. So I have come up with another topic today, that is expression for potential energy of system of three charges in the absence of external field. So this is just to mention the expression. They may ask you for 1 marks question or 2 marks itself. Okay. So in previous video we just studied how to find the potential energy of system of two charges in the absence of external electric field. If suppose they ask three charges, they are placed like this, Q1, Q2 and Q3. Okay. So let us assume that Q1, Q2 are at a distance R12. Q2, Q3 are at a distance R23. Okay. And next, your Q1 and Q3 are at a distance R13 you can take, or 31 you can take. Okay. See, I have gone in this order, cyclic order. Q1, Q2, so the distance I have taken as R12. Q2, Q3, 2 to 3 have taken here. 3 to 1 I have taken here, 3, 1. Okay, this is how we will take it, assume it. Now we need to find potential energy of the system. So how to find potential energy of the system now? System means what we will do, we will take first two charges, then we will find potential energy, next two charges, and then you are going to add all the potentials. For example, see, I will just make you to understand very easily, remember how to do it. If U is the potential energy of this entire system, then how can I get U12 plus U23 plus U31. Okay. Now we need to find U12, U23 and U31, and then we are going to sum it up. Okay. So that's very simple here. So in order to find U1, what will be the work done while bringing U1 means, while bringing the first charge Q1, it will be 0, then you will bring Q2, then this configuration you will see Q1, Q2. Already we have derived the expression for this configuration, directly you can take that expression. So what is it? Right, this is the expression for U1, already we have done it. These Q1 and Q2 in previous derivation we have done. Now you have to take Q2, Q3. So Q2, Q3 means, I'll just close it to make you to understand. So this is the configuration of two charges, right? So same thing you will find, same way, just by inspection you can write the expression here. That is, so it's 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. So what is it now? Here it was Q1, Q2. Now we have to take charges Q2, Q3. So Q2, Q3. What is the distance between them? R23. Okay. Next. 3, 1. Again same. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. What are the charges you are taking? You are taking Q3 and Q1. I just close this. You will understand. Now this system you are taking Q3 and Q1, right? So here charges are Q3 into Q1 divided by, what is the distance here? R31. Okay. So this would be the expression. Now what are you going to do? You are going to add, you are going to add each individual potentials in this equation. Okay, that's very simple. So therefore, I'm going to add these all three. Therefore, the potential energy of a system of three charges in the absence of electric field is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught is common in all the three. Directly I'll write common. I'll take it outside. So what is left out? Q1, Q2 by R12 plus Q2, Q3 by R23 plus Q3, Q1 by R31. Okay. That's it. So this is the final expression that what we get for three charges. So what is the condition here? It is in the absence of external electric field. So if they ask you for four charges like this, okay, it forms what? A square, like, right? So here q1, q2, q3, q4 as such, r1, r2, 3, r3, 4, r4, 1. Distance you can take it, and you can just write the expression for this. q1, q2 by r1, 2, 1 by 4 pi epsilon is common. q1, q2 by r1, 2 plus q2, q3 by r2, 3 plus q3, q4 by r3, 4 plus q4, q1 by r4, 1. And even you may get this two charges also you can find. Okay. 4 to q2, distance will take it as 4, 2. Then q1 to q3 will take distance as r1, 3. Okay. So how did I come to know this? How to take this? See, this is based on combinations like 4C2. Two charges, how many, systems here, two configurations here, four charges, 4C2. So if you get 4C2, if you solve it, you will get six combinations. Okay. So in this way, you can understand and you can just write the expression. So in the examination, they ask you just to mention. Okay. Mention the expression for potential energy of system of three charges anta keladre. This expression, final expression, you have to write. If suppose they ask for four, then I hope you understand and you can write it. Okay. I hope you understood that one. Now we'll move further. That is expression for potential energy for two point charges in the presence of external electric field. So here we are going to find again the same potential energy, but for two point charges, but where? In the presence of external electric field. So what happens if external electric field is already present? Say this is the external electric field. I'll show it by one line. So this is already present here, and somewhere at infinity your q1 and q2 charges are kept. Okay, now we have already marked the positions, say A and B, separated by certain distance. Now what you are going to do, you are going to bring q1 charge. This is the initial configuration, right? ui, this is the initial configuration. See, suppose if you are not watched my previous video, potential energy for two point charges in the absence of external field, then directly you cannot watch this. First adu nodbekagutte, and then come back to this video, then only we'll follow it. So q1 q2 are initially at infinity, and we know that at initial what is potential energy, it is zero. So hence we are concentrating on the final configuration. So in order to build this final configuration, you are bringing q1 charge from infinity to the marked position A. Now while bringing q1 charge from infinity, here see, already external electric field is present, that is E. So now q1 has to be brought from where? From infinity to the point A. So while bringing that q1 in the absence of electric field, work done was zero because there was no external field present, so easily this charge used to come over there. But right now you see the electric field is present here, and while bringing this q1 charge in this electric field, we have to do more work. Why? Because q1 charge is in the presence of external field, and that external field may push it away to infinity. Okay, suppose it positive negative in the hogatad electric field andre, hoda. So ee charge il bandha ಬಂದಿದೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ರಿಪೆಲ್ಡ್ ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ದ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ರೈಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಯೂ ಒನ್ ಸೊ ಅಗೇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಕ್ಯೂ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಬ್ರಾಟ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಎಫ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯೂ ಇ ಈಸ್ ದ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ವಾಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ದೆನ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ಝೀರೋ ದೆನ್ ಕ್ಯೂ ಒನ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ ಹೌದಾ ಸೊ ಇನ್ಫಿನಿಟಿದಿಂದ ನಾವೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ವಿ ಈ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ಗೆ ತರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ವಿ ಆದರೆ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಅಲ್ಲೊಂದು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇದೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಏನು ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಅದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಹಾಕುತ್ತೆ ರೈಟ್ ಸೊ ಅವಾಗ ನಮಗೆ ವರ್ಕ್ ಡನ್ ಮಾಡಲೇಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಪುಷಿಂಗ್ ಓಕೆ ಅಗೇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಮೂವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸೊ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಪುಷ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ಮತ್ತೆ ವಾಪಸ್ ಒರಿಜಿನಲ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ವರ್ಕ್ ಡನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರ ದೆನ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಸ್ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಸೊ ಈ ಥರ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ನಾವೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅದರ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಏಗ ತಂದಿಡ್ತಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಇನ್ಫಿನಿಟಿ ಕ್ಯೂ ಒನ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಈಸ್ ಬ್ರಾಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಾವ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಈಸ್ ಡನ್ ಓಕೆ ವೆರ್ ಆಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಆಬ್ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟರ್ನಲ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಡನ್ ವಾಸ್ ಝೀರೋ ವೈಲ್ ಬ್ರಿಂಗಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ಯೂ ಒನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಇನ್ಫಿನಿಟಿ ಟು ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಎ ಬಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಟು ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ಯೂ ಒನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಇನ್ಫಿನಿಟಿ ದ ವರ್ಕ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಡನ್ ವೈ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡೂ ದಿಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಕ್ಯೂ ಒನ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ರೈಟ್ ಅಗೇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡೂ ದ ವರ್ಕ್ ಸೊ ನಾವು ಆರ್ ವಿ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಡನ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಕ್ಯೂ ಒನ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಡೂ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ So here already we'll assume that V1 and V2 are the potentials. So that was the concept. Now what we are going to assume that V1, V2 are potential at Q1 and Q2 respectively. Right? Then. Okay, V1 is the potential at of Q1 where you are going to find it at B, okay, and V2 is the potential of Q2 charge where you are going to find it at A, okay. So first we will find potential work, potential energy possessed by Q1. So now see what I mean to say is, from infinity Q1 charge is brought to A against the electric field by doing some work. Now work is done, that work done is stored in the form of energy, and that energy we call it as potential energy. So adakke navu igen martidivi, potential energy due to Q1 we are going to find. ಮೊದಲೆಲ್ಲ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ವಿ, ವರ್ಕ್ ಡನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಪೊಟೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಅಂತೆಲ್ಲ ಹೇಳ್ತಿದ್ವಲ್ಲ. ಈಗ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ವಿ ಆರ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ. ಸೊ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ರೈಟ್ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಪೊಸೆಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ Q1 ಈಸ್, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ U1 ಓಕೆ. ಹೌ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ U1 ನಾವು, U1 ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಟು V1 into Q1. How it is? V1 into Q1. How did I get it? By this basic expression. What is it? Potential is equals to work done per charge. Therefore, work done is equals to Q into V. But work done is nothing but, work is nothing but stored in the form of energy, and that energy we call it as potential energy. So, W jagdal U bari boda. So, therefore, U equal to in agate. V Q, right? So since here 1 1, so I have made the subscriptions. I hope you understood up till here. This will be my first equation, right? Similarly, now Q2 charge has to be brought from infinity to point B. Ivaga nodi, ivaga work done will be more compared to this, means Q1 also produces its own field here, as well as there is a field here. So strong field aitu, eva work done has to be more, huh? So more the work done, more work done we have to do, more force is present. So work done no martivi, work is done, and that work done is nothing but stored in the form of energy, and that potential energy I'll take it as U2. So now I'll write here. I hope you can see it properly. Yes. Okay, fine. So I'll write potential energy possessed by which charge in a Q2 charge. Right? So that is, I'll take it as U2. How you're going to find? Again, this basic definition only I'm going to use. Now in place of V, here V2, and in place of Q, here it is Q2. Okay, so these were the potentials, individual potentials, potential energies, individual potential energy. Now as I bring them, here I have brought Q2, right? And the separation, I'll take it as R1 only, R12. Okay, now see, individually I calculated the potential energy. Q1 potential energy is V1 Q1. Q2 potential energy is V2 Q2, right? Now, as a together, as a configuration, as a system of two charges, separated by certain distance, what will be the potential energy that I need to calculate? Andre separation iddaga, matte alli ondu potential energy agutte between these two. So that I have to calculate. So what I shall I write it as? Potential energy possessed by the two charges due to separation. Due to separation is, so how to calculate now? That's very simple. Okay, now we will find potential energy due to system of two charges. Okay, this we have done already, see, in previous video. Q1 Q2 separated by certain distance. Yes, avaga illi electric field irlilla yavaga Q1 taruvaga, but Q1 tandittad mele ee Q1 inde ond electric field build aayithu illi, produce aagta ide illi, right? So hige electric field build aayithu. So that means idu kuda in the presence of electric field adanga aitenilla. So that's why I'll take, make use of that expression itself. That expression I'll take it as U3. So U3 is equals to 1/4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by the separation R12. This I'll mention as equation number 3. Now it's time to find the total potential energy. So therefore, that's very simple derivation we have here. Therefore, total potential energy of the system to build a configuration, I hope you can see it now, is, so I'll take it as total and I'll take it as U. Correct. I'll take it as U equals to U1 plus U2 plus U3. Correct. So U1 is how much? V1 Q1. U2 is V2 Q2. U3 is 1/4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R12. That's it. So hence the final expression. Okay. I hope you understood. So sometimes they may ask you this derivation, or sometimes they just ask to mention, okay, to mention the expression anta keltare, mention the expression for potential energy of system of two charges in the presence of external field andre idin baribeku. Absence of external field andre U equal to 1/4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R12 anta baribeku. Okay, so that's very, very simple derivations I have covered. In my next video, I'll derive the expression for potential energy of an electric dipole. Okay, then, thank you.